Let's look at a basic, straightforward example of finding the equation of a line in space. So here are the directions. Find the equation of the line through point 0, 2, negative 5, and in the direction of the vector 1, negative 1, 1. Okay, so first of all, what's the equation for a line in space? So the general expression looks like this. Vector r, equals vector r 0 plus t times vector v. Okay, so here, vector r sub 0 corresponds to the position vector pointing to the point you're interested in. So here we want an equation of the line through point 0, 2, negative 5. So our vector r 0 is going to be the position vector that goes between the origin and that point. And then vector v is the direction vector of your line. So really this is kind of analogous to point slope form, right? And when you're drawing a line on the two-dimensional plane using point slope form, you're given a point that you want the line to pass through. And then you're also given a slope, which tells you that the direction that the line's going to go in. And that's really what's happening here as well. We're given a point, this time in three-dimensional space, and then we're given a vector that tells us in what direction we want the line to point. Okay, so really all we have to do here is plug in. Okay, so out to the side here, let's just write down what vector r0 is. Once again, this is going to be the vector that goes between points, the point I'm interested in, 0, 2, negative 5, and the origin. So the components of that vector are just going to be 0, 2, negative 5. Okay. And then we're given vector v explicitly. That's just 1, negative 1, 1. Okay, so if I plug that into my expression for the equation of the line, it's going to look like this. Vector r0, so 0, 2, negative 5, plus t. Here t is a scalar quantity, t times vector v. And we could leave this in this form, or we could combine these vectors. So if I were to combine these vectors, it'd look like this. The first component would be 0 plus 1t. And then 2 minus 1t, and then negative 5 plus 1t. Or I could write that as t, comma, 2 minus t, comma, negative 5 plus t. And this gives me the equation of my line in space. So basically, t is my parameter here. If I were to let t vary for all values of t between negative infinity and infinity, this vector-valued function would sweep out the entire line. In this direction, we're asked to find a line through the points p0 at point negative 3, 5, 2, and p1 at point 2, 0, 8. So once again, let's just start by writing down the equation of a line in space. Okay, so that equation is given by vector r equals vector r sub 0 plus t times vector v. Now what we're actually given in this example is simply two points. Okay, in a more simple example, you might be given one point, p0, and then vector v, which gives you the direction of the line, but here I'm just given two points. So this is kind of analogous to the situation, just in two dimensions where you're working in point slope form, and you're just given two points, and you're asked to find the equation of the line between them. So in that case, what you start by doing is actually finding the slope between the two lines. And that's basically what we're going to be doing here. Instead of finding the slope, we're going to be finding the direction vector v between these two points. Okay, so let's start by then finding vector v. So vector v then is going to be the vector that goes between points p0 and p1. Okay, so if I work that out just using the points p1 and p0, The components of that vector are going to be 2 minus negative 3, 0 minus 5, and then 8 minus 2. And if I work that out, that's going to give me 5, negative 5, and 6 as the components of my vector v. Now from here, I'm basically doing what I would do in any other equation of the line problem. I have my point b0, so from that I can write down r0, right? That's r0 is just the vector that goes between the origin and point p0, so its components are just negative 3, 5, 2. And so then I just plug into my formula, because I have r0, and I have vector v. So then the equation of my line, vector r, is going to be given by vector r0, so negative 3, 5, 2, plus t times vector v, which was 5, negative 5, 6. So if I actually go through and add these vectors, I'm going to get negative 3 plus 5t, and then 5 minus 5t, and then 2 plus 6t. And this gives me the equation of my line in space.